Yeah, is what I would say. And I think these are related, and now it's like, well, how does that happen? How can it be that we have a sandstone that's about 2,000 feet wide here, coming out of, gently dipping, and then we have the Great Monument over clear on the other side of the mountain? How do they tie together? We're gonna figure that out.
Many people would find this area to be a great place to explore and hike around in, enjoying the beauty that surrounds them. But in my view, without contemplating the history and geology they are traversing, they are missing out on another level of profound enjoyment and amazement. This relatively ordinary exposure of sandstone is providing me an opportunity to unravel mysteries and ponder the age of dinosaurs. Notice that the sandstone goes underground into the hillside right along the dashed red line. Looking carefully, you can see the edge of the sandstone body right here. There is none to be seen to the left along this hillside. Also, you can see the edge here on the right side. Again, there's no more sandstone to the right along the hillside. The width from edge to edge is about 2,000 feet.
Of course, the GMC Terrain offers all-wheel drive mode. What about Supernova mode or Weekend Warrior mode? You don't see that everyday mode. How about out of the office mode? Or even mode? Want a mode for everything? GMC Terrain. Just in time for the holidays, get 1.9% APR on 2024 Terrain models. Plus, no monthly payments for 90 days.
Numbers move you, but some can stop you in your tracks. Like the tens of thousands of people who were diagnosed with certain HPV-related cancers. For most people, HPV clears on its own. But for those who don't clear the virus, it can cause certain cancers. Gardasil 9 is a vaccine given to adults through age 45 that can help protect against certain diseases caused by HPV, including cervical, vaginal, vulvar, anal, and certain head and neck cancers, such as throat and back of mouth cancers and genital warts. Gardasil 9 doesn't protect everyone and does not treat cancer or HPV infection. Your doctor may recommend screening for certain HPV-related cancers. Women still need routine cervical cancer screenings. You shouldn't get Gardasil 9 if you've had an allergic reaction to the vaccine, its ingredients, or are allergic to yeast. Tell your doctor if you have a weakened immune system, are pregnant, or plan to be. The most common side effects include injection site reactions, headache, fever, nausea, dizziness, tiredness, diarrhea, abdominal pain, and sore throat. Fainting can also happen. Help protect what counts. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist about Gardasil 9.
As you will recall, the monument has a similar constrained width. These observations indicate that the sandstone body has a long and narrow shape. So with these observations, it's clear to me that these two sandstone bodies were at one time connected together. And to better understand this, let's review the structural and erosional history of the rock formations. The many thousands of feet of rock layers that were originally flat line were folded in dramatic ways about 65 million years ago and then eroded to their present configuration. I've put in a red line to show the top of the cloverleaf formation, which is where the sandstones reside, and show how it was folded prior to erosion. Now I'm sure you've noticed that the layers of rock bend around a corner here, along the nose of the fold. To understand that better, watch my video on mountain making and folding rocks.
Now that we've established this is a long and narrow sandstone body, we start to have fun. We think about where do we deposit sandstone bodies like this. And to help us out with that, I've got my whiteboard. And this is a map view looking down from above. I've put in the ocean here with my fancy little wave symbol. And then, of course, this would be land up through here. And we're familiar with beaches. You've walked along a beach. And we know that, I'll put some dots here, the sand is fairly constrained along the beach. At least what we see is. And it seems to be a narrow band of sand along the beach. That's a reasonable hypothesis, of course. But it turns out that beaches almost always deposit blankets of sand, not narrow bodies. Through time, they spread out a blanket of sand. That's another discussion. So this for a geologist to go, well, there are cases where you can get isolated beach sands that are narrow. It's pretty unusual. So you kind of think about this. I think, not so sure. So let's keep it there. Well, those of you that are familiar with the ocean and oceanic processes know about barrier islands and spits, they call them, spit bars. Kind of a strange name. So if we have longshore currents, meaning waves that are coming in at an angle, when it comes to a point along a bay here or something, or it doesn't even have to be a bay, a point of land, it starts building out a sandbar that comes out like this into a spit. Or sometimes the bar goes clear across the bay or the lagoon, and they're called barrier island bars. So those are certainly narrow and can be quite long bodies of sand. And 2,000 feet wide, that seems pretty reasonable. So that's a very viable hypothesis. And the last option that we'll entertain for now is a river deposit. Of course rivers are long and fairly narrow. And we know dinosaurs were running around on the land out here, so let's put in a river. So I'll have a river coming down to the ocean right here. Okay, so now we have a river coming through and depositing sand. So which option is it? Well, as I've mentioned, the beach thing is kind of unusual, pretty unlikely. What about the spit bar and the barrier island bar? Well, geologists can look at the sedimentary structures or the depositional features within the sandstones, and they also look at the deposits adjacent to the sand and just underneath and just above, and they take all that information and they can determine if it's marine, deposited in a marine environment, or in particular whether it's a barrier island bar, for example. And after doing that work, it's a no. Nope. It's not a marine deposit like that. So we're left with the river. Fairly straightforward, huh? And in fact, it's a river and they see evidence, geologists do, of some marine influence, some tidal influence within that river. So that tells us it's likely within a few miles of the ocean, of the actual shoreline. Now we have the full picture. It's a sandstone deposit within a fairly large river system. After all, it's about 2,000 feet wide. Pretty big river likely through here, coming down towards the shoreline of the ocean. This is pretty neat to think about. And then you think about the structural history and how it got warped. Now I want you to take a minute and think about your favorite river that you like to float down or maybe hike along. Imagine that river in the future being bent, warped in a giant uplift and fold like a giant roller coaster that we see here. Even turning vertical, being vertical in parts, or very near vertical. That is crazy to think about, isn't it?
Wow, so the river sandstone deposits were uplifted and folded and were nearly vertical on the left side of the fold before being eroded down. That's really hard to get your head around. Furthermore, the cross-stratification we have observed indicates that the river flowed from left to right. Now to the interesting distribution of the large boulders scattered about. The whiteboard will certainly help us with that.
So I've drawn a cross-sectional sketch. I have a tree here to help us understand that. We're looking sideways. This is the sandstone monument here. This is the ground surface here. So I could put another tree over here. These are boulders that are breaking.